Did you know that whales evolved from a land-based animal into an ocean-going mammal? To look into the evidence, we need to look at the desert, which I know sounds a bit strange when talking about whales. But did you know that the ocean used to roam across the current location of the Egyptian desert? Approximately 37 million years ago, prehistoric creatures used to swim around the enormous Tethys Ocean at what is today the dry and windy West Egyptian desert. A graveyard of fossilized whale bones demonstrates the evolution of whales. My name is Kaylee, and today we're going to look at the incredible location that is Wadi El-Hitan, also known as the Whale Valley. Located approximately 190 kilometers southwest of Cairo, this is the most important site in the world for the demonstration of the evolution of whales. The common ancestor of whales and all other land animals was a flat-headed salamander-shaped tetrapod that threw itself out of the sea onto muddy banks about 360 million years ago. Its descendants gradually evolved the function of their lungs, their fins into legs, and their jaw joints to hear in the air instead of water. 60 million years ago, these evolved mammals turned out to be the most successful of the animal kingdom. But whales were among a tiny handful of mammals that made an evolutionary U-turn, evolving back to eat, move, sense, and mate underwater. How whales accomplished this enormous transformation has baffled scientists for a very long time. Charles Darwin recognized the conundrum as one of the great challenges to his theory of evolution by natural selection. He eventually omitted his theory surrounding whales from later editions of his books. Ancient prehistoric species of whales used to roam around the enormous Tethys Ocean, after death sinking to the bottom of the sea. For thousands of millennia, sediments built up covering the bones, and as the sea receded, the former seafloor became a desert. The wind then started to blow away the sandstone that had built up on top of these bones, and after thousands of years, the bones peaked above the sand. Then, one day, back in 1902, a team of geologists were traveling into a valley in the Egyptian western desert. Centuries of strong wind has sculpted the sandstone rocks, and at night the sand glowed like gold in the brightness of the moonlight. This desolate, dreamlike place has no water. But this dry valley is the place where these geologists came across hundreds of skeletons of whales and other prehistoric creatures. These skeletons date back to an era when a somewhat shallow tropical sea covered northern Egypt approximately 37 million years ago. Geologists at the time didn't realize it, but these prehistoric specimens would offer clues to the question, how did whales become whales? Because these fossilized whale remains had feet. Scientists had long suspected that whales once were mammals that had eased into ocean life over the course of millions of years, over time losing their four legs. Modern whales have vestigial hind leg bones, so this suspicion had a strong basis. Unfortunately, there was not much in the fossil records that illustrated this transition. That all changed when University of Michigan's paleontologist Philip Gingerich began excavating Wadi El-Hitan in the 1980s, where he came across hundreds of whale fossils where he eventually found legs and knees in 1989, when they were excavating a Basilosaurus skeleton. Curator of fossil marine mammals at the National Museum of Natural History said that these skeletons are the Rosetta Stone of whale evolution, as this was the first time we could see what the hind limbs of these animals looked like, and they are bizarre. There have been older specimens found of footed whales in other locations in the world, but Wadi El-Hitan's fossils are unmatched in their numbers and excellent state of preservation. All whale fossils are from the now extinct suborder of whales called the Archaeoceti, and almost all fossils found belong to two types. The Basilosaurus was giant with an eel-like body, and the Dorudon, which looked more like the modern whale, being more heavy and petite. The main difference between the modern whale and the Dorudon was the teeth. The modern whale has peg-like teeth, while the Dorudon had serrated daggers. The current location of Wadi El-Hitan in prehistoric times was most likely a warm, nutrient-rich gulf like the modern Baja California, where gray whales today give life to their young. Paleontologist Philip Gingerich believed that the Dorudon calved in the shallows, much like the modern gray whales. There are an unusual number of juvenile skeletons at the site. Some of these skeletons bear bite marks on their heads, most likely inflicted by the larger Basilosauruses. Some Darudan skeletons were found with a variety of fish bones where their stomachs would have been, giving some insight in their diet. The Basilosaurus was a whale with two delicate hind legs, each the size of a three-year-old's leg, protruding from its flanks. These little limbs were perfectly formed, but completely useless for walking. They are crucial to understanding how modern whales became supremely adapted swimmers. The complete specimen of the Basilosaurus are the whale's Rosetta Stones, said Gingrich, as they tell us more about how the animal lived than the fragmentary remains that are found. In the 1990s, molecular biologists studying the genetic code of these ancient whales concluded that the whale's closest living relative is the hippopotamus. In 2007, Gingrich found the fossilized remains of Aegisetus gehennae, which was the first late Eocene protocetid. Protocetids are early semi-aquatic whales from the Eocene, a geological epoch that started 56 million years ago and ended 33.9 million years ago. Modern whales used their tails to propel themselves through the water, but early protocetid whales were semi-aquatic and swam mainly by using their limbs. About 37 million years ago, the protocetids adapted more to the water and became tail-powered swimmers. This particular creature, the Aegisetus gehennae, has been well adapted for swimming, using the mid-body and tail, much like crocodiles swim today. The body of this creature is similar to that of the ancient Basilosaurus, which is found in abundant numbers in Wadi El-Hitan. The most complete specimen has been found at Wadi El-Hitan and is believed to be a male. It would have weighed nearly 2,000 pounds during its lifetime and would have been approximately 12 feet long. Alongside the whale skeletons lie the fossilized remains of sirenians and reptiles, as well as shark teeth from a shark species that lived 41 million years ago. For the past 37 years, Professor Gingrich and his colleagues have located the remains of more than 400 whales in Wadi El-Hitan, the Valley of the Whales, and there are countless more to be discovered in the future. By discovering these fossils, they have been able to fill in the story of the evolution of early whales. They were hippo-like creatures and inhabited swampy lowlands in the Eocene times. The earliest whales appeared approximately 55 million years ago, during the spike in global temperatures and the beginning of the Eocene. Living along the eastern shores of the Tethys, the waters exerted a strong evolutionary pull. Tethys was warm, salty, rich in marine life, and free of aquatic dinosaurs. Chasing new food sources deeper into the water, they gradually developed longer snouts and sharper teeth. 50 million years ago, they were great four-legged swimmers that still moved around on land. Approximately 45 million years ago, the water environment drew the whales farther out to sea, evolving their necks to get more compressed and stiffened. Their toes stretched and grew webbing similar to duck feet. Over time, as they continued to dive deeper, their eyes gradually migrated from the top to the sides of their head. Even though they were finely tuned to live in the water, they still had to throw themselves onto land on their webbed fingers and toes in search of fresh water and to bear young. This all changed with both the Basilosaurus and the Darudan some 40 million years ago, as they both had never set foot on land, crossing the ocean all the way to the shores of modern-day Peru. The final transition from Basilosaurids to modern whales began 34 million years ago, during the sudden phase of cooling, which ended the Eocene epoch. A drop in water temperatures near the poles, shifting ocean currents, and an upwelling of nutrient-rich seawater along the western shores of Africa and Europe drew the whales into their new environments and drove the remaining evolutionary adaptations. The big rains, echolocation, insulating blubber, and in some species, baleen in place of teeth for straining krill. Wadi El-Hitan has been a UNESCO World Heritage Site since July 2005. Approximately 14,000 people visit this unique location and its marvelous fossils each year. The site is well managed and well protected. It remains in an excellent state of preservation. But the site does deal with conservation threats, especially when it comes to visitor numbers increasing. Thus, the chances of the fossils being trampled by people or vehicles become larger. Theft of fossils is another threat the site has to deal with, as there is little protection against it. Many of them are just lying on the surface and can be easily picked up, which makes the threat of theft from the site very real. Natural erosion, as you can imagine, possess a threat as well. The wind and water at the site lead to new fossils becoming exposed, and other fossils might get lost and buried once more. In some cases, exposed parts of valuable fossils might require a special protection from erosion, and may get embedded by polymer, so it won't get lost forever. I highly recommend going to this site if you're planning a trip to Egypt, as it must be an incredible sight to see these fossils in the open. But with that said, you've reached the end of this video. If you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click the bell icon for notifications every time I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner or click the link in the description down below. I also would like to thank my Patreons, Richard, Barry, Floyd, and NGC6543. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.